Hi, and welcome to episode 3 of Photographer Stories. My name is Matthew Robert Joseph. This episode, I was going to say week, but I don't do them every week. It's not a weekly thing. I do them when I can. So this episode, I'm talking to Cameron Stephen, aka Art Punk. His website is www.theplasticlens.com. Yeah, we have a chat. It goes on a bit. I'm really sorry. I'm really sorry that it goes on for so long, but we were having such a good chat, and we were sitting on the balcony of his house in the country, and it was glorious, and people use the word glorious too much, but there was a lot of glory. Yeah, great chat, top bloke. Yeah, really happy with what we produced today. Yeah, here it is. Turn your ears on, because it's coming at you. Hi.
Hi.
Wait, I always start with a hi.
It's always good to.
Yeah.
Start with a hi.
Start with a hi, and then work our way down. End on a low. Thank you for having me out here.
It's my pleasure, Matthew.
It's beautiful out here. Mm. We're in Monbulk in Melbourne, famous for its jam, I believe.
Yeah, unfortunately they don't have the jam factory up here anymore.
No, is it gone?
Yeah, it's name only. I think it's moved. It's probably produced in New Zealand. A lot of stuff's produced in New Zealand.
All the good stuff.
All the good stuff.
All the good stuff's produced.
It's got nothing to do with the economics. Yes, they used to make jam up here.
Yeah,
there's still a lot of nurseries and mainly nursery supplies and plants and Flemings is up here.
Okay,
and a few other providers to the nurseries down in town.
Yeah,
lots of good soil.
Yes. Yep. So, what's your name? Who are you?
Oh. My apologies. Assumption is the mother of all stuff-ups. I'm Cameron.
You're Cameron.
Hi. I'm Cameron. What was the other question? Yes, I'm Cameron. Sorry, yeah. I'm Cameron. I've known your good interviewer, Matthew, for how long have we known? About 8, 9 years, maybe?
Not that long.
You sure? When did you come to Australia?
I came to Australia the second time in 2007.
Okay. So maybe 7 or 8.
2008.
Yeah. Okay. It's coming up to 6, 7 years.
But yeah. You're a Flickr alumni.
Yes. Not so much lately, since they've changed their API.
Oh, you don't like it?
Oh, I don't know. I sort of maybe because I've had other interests, but I've found I haven't been on Flickr as often as I used to. I used to develop my stuff and scan it in, and I'd upload everything, which was probably really annoying to people that followed me. And I do apologise for that. I used to use Flickr almost like a cloud storage before cloud storage became popular. I'd upload as high a resolution as I could just in case I lost my hard drive. Yeah. Of course, I back up.
Yeah, you know, we all back up.
We all back up, don't we?
Negs. Negatives are my backup. Yeah,
negatives are my backup too. Yeah. But living in an area that's during the fire danger period is prone to, there are concerns that my negatives may come up in smoke one day, but... that's just one of the things that you...
I think that's the last thing I would care about.
Yeah, I don't worry about it too much. I care more about the family. Let's see, eagle.
Oh, look at that.
Yeah. Sorry, I've just got distracted.
It's a bird. A large
bird of prey in the air.
Flying high.
Looking for mice and other small crunchy things to eat.
Yeah. I just heard a fly. That was awesome.
Because you never get them in Australia.
No flies on me. So you're
Flickr alumni.
Yeah.
Alumni.
Well, you know,
I'm part of the Melbourne Silver Mine on Flickr, and
you're Art Punk.
I am slightly embarrassing username.
You don't have to be embarrassed. I mean, look at my name. It's like most people can't pronounce it. Like, the awkward moment is like, oh, you're fotodudenz. What was I thinking?
Oh, photo dude New Zealand. Yeah, that's right.
Thank you, Cam. Thank you.
We're
sitting on the balcony of your beautiful house in Monbok, and the sun's out, and there's...
So nice to have the sun out after a few grey days.
Oh, it's good. Yeah. And there's animals and stuff around, or birds. Birds are animals.
They are animals.
They are animals.
Yeah. Lots of birds up here. Lots of birds.
But yeah, when I say Flickr alumni, I'm like, there's so many new people on Flickr.
Yes. Like, it's hard to keep up.
I think it... I was looking at... What was I looking at the other day? I was looking at, like... I was having a look at people I follow on Flickr.
Yep.
And removing the people who haven't uploaded something in 70 months. You know, like people who have deserted Flickr. That might have
been me.
No, you weren't in that list at all.
Funnily enough, I was thinking of uploading something to Flickr the other day. I just haven't got around to it yet.
And I was looking at... who... I might actually move this.
Yeah, would you like to...
No, it's all right. We're going to... This is raw
audio. The truck carrying plants from the nursery.
What was I getting at? Yeah, so...
You were culling your Flickr content.
Half the people who follow me, half them, when there's about 2,000 or something, have appeared in the last 12 months.
That's bizarre.
It is bizarre. Mm. It's like 6 years or however many years I've been on, and then half of that, like double that amount, is in the last 12 months.
Well, that shows me that I'm probably a bit old school.
Yeah.
And I've got... too used to the old interface of Flickr. For those that don't know, Flickr has been owned by Yahoo for a while now. I think is Google own Yahoo?
No.
They're opposites.
Someone is going to buy Yahoo.
So Yahoo have changed the interface on Flickr and the way that they display your photographs that you've uploaded and. Sort of the forums seem to be pretty much the same, but the whole interface and
everyone's
and the
way, wrong.
Yeah. Basically, as is on any online forum, unless you're showing pictures of cats or your latest meal, you'll have discussion that can become quite heated, as I've discovered on Facebook when I. Become a bit stirring. I was banned from Facebook for 24 hours.
Really?
Yeah, I was on the asylum seekers resource page, someone was trolling, saying everybody that supported asylum seekers were leftards loony lefties and stuff. And I basically said something like, "I'm very sorry that you're not in touch with your humanity." Humanitarian side, and I hope you feel better soon. And apparently, that was enough to get me banned for 24 hours. Yeah, everybody was laughing. I thought it was a great joke that I was banned from Facebook
because Facebook isn't the internet.
No,
the internet is you can do whatever you want. You know, you can fucking swear on your fucking podcast.
Oh, but we won't fucking swear because it gives us the shits. You know, swearing. It gives some people the shits.
But you can do whatever you want, but...
Fuck you, Matt.
Yeah.
I'll do whatever I want. You can't.
What'd you call me?
What is it you can't face?
But Facebook...
Sorry about that little...
No, it's good.
Silly there.
It's good.
Facebook, ever since I've seen that film...
Yeah.
The Love Guru... Yeah. You can't hear that sentence without thinking. Yeah, what did you just say to me?
They need to put a skipping track right before it, just so you can repeat it over and over.
Pardon me.
That's fine.
Facebook is not
the internet.
It is a...
And it's not free speech.
It is a entity that is owned by Facebook.
Yeah.
And it has its own rules of conduct.
That's right.
And if you breach those rules... Apparently it's all right to call people leftards, which actually insults people with...